grab a book, friend, and take a look inside. Pick up a paperback and turn the page.
If all adventure is what you're looking for, that's why a library is all the rage.
Bio-westerns, spooky mysteries, fairy tales and
tales of your grandpa's watch.
Pick a pop, look around at other worlds. Plot, of course, never let the facts get in your way. You can't touch stars if you're looking at the ground. You can't fly high. A fantasy can fool and flabbergast. A silly anecdote may still amaze.
That dusty fable that's hung around for years might turn your head around the other way.
Hey, Rose! Looks like you're ready to tell us all a story.
That's right, Chucky. What do you want to hear?
I always like chicken licking.
How about Sleeping Beauty?
Oh, I want to hear Hansel and Gretel.
The Ugly Duckling is my favorite.
Rose, could we hear the story of Little Red Riding Hood?
Of course you can. Chucky, why don't you start us off?
Glad to. Once, there was a girl named Little Red Riding Hood.
Little Red Riding Hood? That's her name?
Well, I thought it was what she was wearing.
Anyhow, Red was skipping through the woods taking a basket of goodies to her grandma.
Oh, that's sweet!
I don't understand. Is that her name or what she's wearing?
Can we get on with this? It's both.
Sorry, Red!
Try to lend a helping hand. Be the one to understand. Reach across this magic land. You can make a difference.
We all need help sometimes. Even guys in nursery rhymes. Just standing is a crime. You should make a difference.
Red Riding Hood was skipping through the woods with a basket of goodies when she ran right into a wolf.
Whoops, excuse me.
Good afternoon, young lady. Where are you going in such a hurry?
I'm taking some goodies to my grandma's house to cheer her up.
That wolf sure looks scary. Ooh.
Grandma's a little upset because her TV's broken.
Oh, too bad. Is there anything I can do to help?
Not unless you know how to fix a busted television. Well, sorry, Mr. Wolf, but I gotta go. Goodbye.
But I'm a good guy. Really.
Satisfaction guaranteed. You can make a difference.
Charity is unrehearsed. Put another person first. When you find a rose reverse,
friends will make a difference.
It's that sneaky wolf.
No, don't do that.
I'm coming, Grandma.
Wait. No, stop.
Grandma, I thought your TV was busted.
Was it busted? I just had to replace this tube. I tried to tell you I was a good guy.
We all have better instincts. Listen for the little voice to stir you right. There's good in every creature.
They may try to hide it, but don't give up, you're sure to find it. Try to lend a helping hand. Be the one to understand. Reach across this magic land. You can make a difference.
Another story for you in just a few minutes.
While we're getting ready for our next part of our show, kick back, relax, and check this out.
The Thirsty Crow.
One hot day, a thirsty crow was looking for some water to drink. He looked everywhere. But he couldn't find it.
Oh, I'm so thirsty. Where can I find some water?
After searching and searching, the crow finally found a bottle with some water in it.
Phew, finally, some water!
The crow was excited. He couldn't wait to drink the water. But when he put his beak into the bottle, he couldn't reach the water. You see, there was only a little bit at the bottom.
Oh, even though I've found water, I still can't drink it.
The thirsty crow thought for a moment and came up with a brilliant idea.
Ah, yes, that's it. I'm going to drink this water once and for all.
The thirsty crow picked up pebbles and dropped them into the bottle, one by one. The water inside the bottle began to rise and rise, until finally, he could drink the water.
Oh, finally! Some water! Sip, sip.
And so, the thirsty crow wasn't thirsty anymore.
Favorite parts about this camera is all the cool photo effects. Guys, you want to take a picture?
Yeah!
I love this picture. Look at the filter.
Everybody wants to be my enemy. Spare the sympathy. Everybody wants to be my enemy.
What's gonna be my prey? Look at my mighty teeth, look at my mighty jaws. Nothing can run away from me.
Tyrannosaurus Rex.
I'm the best hunter.
Tyrannosaurus Rex.
What's gonna be my prey? Look at my keen eyes, look at my keen nose. Nothing can hide from me.
T stands for toothy.
T-Rex.
T stands for tall.
T-Rex.
T stands for terrible.
T-Rex.
Tyrannosaurus Rex.
I am the best hunter.
Tyrannosaurus Rex.
What's gonna be my prey? Listen to my foot stomp, listen to my loud roar. Nothing can stay calm in front of me. Nothing can stay calm in front of me.
Search for Pinkfong on YouTube.
Everybody, no matter where you go, can feel left out of things along the way.
You lose at some games, you win at others, though. But you can't win, kids, unless you play.
Every drama is a lesson. Pay attention.
Someday there will be a test.
Pick a lock, let a hike in other shoes. Take a look.
Chucky, the story we're about to see is true. Only the bird has been changed to protect the innocent. It happened many years ago, on a Thursday.
Some people dress up in far-off colors. Some dress in black, even on sunny days in May.
Our taste in clothing may be quite different, but we're alike in so many other ways.
New kinds of food and new kinds of music make the world go around. So get with the motion, don't be a prude. Discover music that is strange and foreign to your ear, a tune you'll love to hear.
It takes all kinds of sail and ocean to build a dream, to share a notion. It takes all kinds of fill a grandstand, make a brass band, and win a championship.
Miss Henny, you move like a dream on wheels.
Looking mighty graceful there, Helen. I'll bet you made a wonderful cheerleader.
Yeah.
No, Mr. Munch. I needed a lot more practice before I could be a real cheerleader. But most of all, I needed a friend to believe in me and stick with me while I was learning. Lucky for me, I found such a friend that very same day.
That new arrival who seems so different might be a sister deep inside, we're just the same.
We all look strange to other strangers. We need to find a new way to play this game.
Stretch out a hand, you'll find another hand is reaching for yours. So make a connection.
Lines that divide and build a bridge one day to sweep away our differences and show the world what love is.
It takes all kinds to start a fashion, to stop a fight, to build a passion. It takes all kinds to brave our weather, pull it together, and see a dream coming true. It takes all kinds to sing a ditty, to live a legend, to build a city. It takes all kinds to brave our weather, together and
sing
our dream coming true.
Lots more stories heading your way, so don't dance off, cause we'll be back.
Before we continue with the next part of our show, Here's something you'll like as much as pizza.
The Fox and the Stork. One day, a fox invited a stork to her house for a meal. The fox brought out two flat plates with soup on them.
Stork, the meal is nothing fancy, but I hope you like it.
The fox deliciously lapped up all of the soup on her plate.
Yum! This is so good! Eat up, stork!
But the stork wasn't able to taste it. The stork's beak was too long and pointy to eat the soup off of the flat dish.
Oh, stork, you must not like the soup. Then I shall eat your soup for you.
The next day, the stork invited the fox over to her house for a meal. The stork put some soup into two long, thin-necked jars.
Fox, this is a special family recipe. I hope you enjoy it.
The stork put her beak in the long, thin-necked jar, and she ate soup.
Yum! This is my favorite soup.
But this time, the fox wasn't able to taste it. Her wide snout couldn't fit inside the thin, long-necked jar.
Oh, I'm sorry, Fox. I guess you must not like the soup.
As the stork said again how yummy the soup was, she began to eat all of Fox's soup, too.
Yum!
To me last night.
What?
It was really wild.
Oh, no.
I looked into
Hold it, Munch. He said spanning the globe, not spanking the globe.
It's time for the Chuck E. Cheese News.
Well, hello, news watchers. Have I got a story for you? Well, have I? Now, where did I do it? Oh, here it is. Ladies and gentlemen, this just in. Okay, that was just in, and this is just out. In, out. In, out. Okay? Boy, am I glad we finally got that cleared up. Now, let's see. What's in the news? History was made today when our own Pasquale became the first pizza cook to set foot on the moon. And now, let's talk to him live. Come in, Pasquale. Come in.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, boy, that's a messy.
Come in, Pasquale.
Oh, Chucky. And TV people. Oh, ciao, everybody. Hello, Mama.
Pasquale, just why did you want to be the first pizza cook on the moon?
Well, Chucky, I'd heard the moon was made of green cheese, but I just couldn't believe it. Now that I'm here, I see that it's not green cheese. It's mozzarella cheese, just like I thought.
Fascinating. Any other discoveries?
Why, sure. The surface of the moon has a very unusual crust.
What's unusual about it?
Well, it's chewy, yet crisp, and has just a touch of garlic to
now
it.
Hold on.
Oh, I've also discovered that the moon's mountains are mushrooms, and the credits are really pepperoni.
Pasquale, are you trying to tell us that the moon is really a giant pizza? That idea sounds half-baked to me.
Well, it is half-baked. I'd recommend putting the whole moon into a 350-degree oven for about another 20 minutes or so, and then perfecto! And now, back to you, Chucky.
Thank you, Pasquale.
You're welcome.
Well, folks, that report from outer space has run us out of time. So, until next time, this is Chuck E. Cheese saying, if something important is happening somewhere, it's news to me.
Go up to the sky. Let's see our solar system. Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. Jupiter, Saturn.
Wow, they're big.
Uranus, Neptune, round and round. Go, 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 go. Eight planets. Small, small, so small. Mercury.
So small.
Brightest of all, Venus.
Shiny.
For Pinkfong on YouTube.
Your world is teeming with amazing characters. It takes all kinds, kids, to tell a tale. There was a beauty who liked to nap all day. Her folks tried everything to no avail. Sleeping Beauty had a problem. She would fall asleep at the drop of a hat. Pick a pot, look around in other worlds. Life's a dream. Let another dreamer show the way. You'll never soar if you're staring at the floor. Look up, there's magic in store.
Well, Rose, what story are we gonna hear now? Rose?
What the freak would she, Jasper?
Oh, good morning, everybody. I'm
sorry. I was just doing some research.
Well, that was some awful loud research.
Sounded like you might have been dreaming up our next story.
Yeah, what about that, Rose? What's next?
Chucky, meet a lady with a problem.
Once a princess got in a mess of trouble. Her dad and mother, the king and the lovely queen decreed.
Sleeping Beauty was beautiful, kind, and sound of mind. But Sleeping Beauty was always sound asleep.
The greatest prince, wisest man of any land, all shook their heads, shouted, "We don't understand."
There's a time and place for everything. Gotta tailor your behavior to the current fling. You're gonna learn a lot of songs to sing. There's a proper day, a time and place for every single thing.
Chucky, what's wrong with the princess?
Looks like she might have missed a nap.
That's Sleeping Beauty, gang.
Oh.
A witch put a spell on her many years ago, and she's been sleeping like that ever since.
Nice work if you can get it.
Munchie, even you can't eat while you're sleeping.
Oh, but if I could.
Oh, seems to me our princess is missing out on a few things.
What happened next, Chucky?
One day the princess met her a handsome fella.
Well, she didn't really meet him.
He charmed her folks while Beauty dozed.
Then at dinner, he told her she was perfect. And so pretty, even with her eyes closed.
They fell in love, just like any other team.
While Beauty slept, he shared with her his hopes and dreams.
There's a time and place for everything. Gotta tailor your behavior to the current fling. Sing your song to someone who can hear you sing. There's a proper day, a time and place for every single thing.
I sure don't hold out a lot of hope for these kids.
Yeah, they make a lovely couple. But only one of them knows it.
Beauty missed it when the prince told her that he loved her. Then he kissed her, and son of a gun, the girl woke up. The prince was happy, said he'd be back tomorrow. But she asked nicely if he could hang out till the sun came up.
The prince was up, hours past his belly by. He needed sleep, but the prince.
Get yourself in sync with what life brings. There's a proper day, a time and place for every single thing.
If this might be the proper time to end this story.
Suits me. I'm ready for a nap.
Better make it a short one, Munch. We'll be back with more in just a few minutes. We need to make some special preparations for our next portion of the show. So we thought you'd like to see something really cool.
The Lion and the Mouse. One sunny day, a lion was resting after eating a wonderful meal. When, all of a sudden, a busy mouse that was running around accidentally bumped into him.
How dare you carelessly wake me up like that?
The lion got up and caught the mouse. He was just about to eat him. But the scared little mouse begged the lion for mercy.
Oh, great lion, please spare me. I know that one day you will need my help. Squeak, squeak.
Exactly what can a little mouse like you do to help a big lion like me? Anyway, I'm already full, so I will let you go.
The lion laughed loudly and set the mouse down. A few days later, the lion got caught in a hunter's trap. He hung there helplessly.
Help! Help! Please! Somebody help me!
The lion was stuck in the net and couldn't move at all. Just then, the little mouse heard the lion's cries. So, he went to see what was going on.
Mr. Lion, hang tight! I will save you! Squeak! Squeak!
The mouse started to gnaw on one piece of the net, and then another. Until finally, the lion was free.
My little friend, thank you for saving me. I will never underestimate you or your size again.
The lion apologized to his new little friend.
Thank you so much, Mouse. You truly saved me.
You're welcome, my big friend.
Gonna tell you about a friend of mine who may sound kind of funny. He's a very special little bee who's not into making honey.
Now don't get scared, don't go on alert. When this bee stings, it does not hurt.
He isn't bad, just magic, you see.
'Cause he shows you what you'll grow up to be.
Like this.
He's the what do you want to be? And if you're young, you might get stung by the what do you want to be? He can show any future that happens to suit ya.
So let's get buzzing, cousin.
Let's get his point and rock the joint.
When you get that sting, you'll start to swing
with the what do you want to be?
Donna wants to be a doctor to help make people well.
Freddy wants to be a fireman. He'll ring that fire bell.
Leonard wants to be the librarian who takes care of all the books.
And Pam wants to be a policewoman who catches nasty crooks.
He's the what do you want to be? And if you're young, you might get stung by the what do you want to be? He can show any future that happens to suit ya.
So let's get buzzing, cousin.
Let's get his point and rock the joint.
When you get that sting, you'll start to swing
with the what do you want to be?
Sam wants to be a sailor who works on great big boats.
Sarah wants to be a singer who hits those real high notes.
Kevin wants to be a carpenter. He thinks that would be great.
And Penelope wants to be president of these United States.
He's the what do you want to be? And if you're young, you might get stung by the what do you want to be? He can show any future that happens to suit ya.
So let's get buzzing, cousin.
Let's get his point and rock the joint.
When you get that sting, you'll start to swing
with the what do you want to be?
It's time for some jokes. Some jokes from Pasquale.
It's time for some jokes. Some jokes from Pasquale. Some jokes from Pasquale.
Hey, everyone. Ready for a laugh race? Okay, on your marks. Get set. Go. Okay, why did the wheel take a nap? Give up. It was a tired. Tired, like tire, right? Oh, when we stop laughing. All right, the next joke. Why was the makeup artist kicked out of the hardware store? Are you ready? They were painting all of the nails. They're not supposed to paint those nails. But I bet they were still pretty. All right, folks. It's time to cross the comedy of finish line. So, why are squids so good at football? You give up? They always get 10 tackles. You get it? 10 tackles? 10 tentacles! Tentacles!
Daddy!
Mommy!
Brother!
Sister! And I'm baby!
Happy vroom vroom family!
Oh yeah!
Daddy is driving to work. Vroom vroom, beep beep, vroom vroom, beep.
Mommy is driving to the pool. Vroom vroom, splash! Vroom vroom, splash!
Brother is driving to the zoo. Vroom vroom, eek eek, vroom vroom, eek.
Ooh, ooh, ah, ah.
Vroom vroom, family!
Oh yeah!
Sister is driving to school.
Search for Pinkfong on YouTube.
Hey, Munch, what are you doing back here? We gotta get back inside to perform in a minute.
Oh, hi, Jasper. I'm just working in the garden.
You have a garden back here?
Oh, yeah, it's great. In fact, I think under the purple fur on my hand, I got a green thumb. I'll have to shave my thumb later to be sure.
Nah, you don't need to do that, buddy. I can already tell that you're a natural. What you watering?
A pizza plant!
A pizza plant?
Yep.
How is that even possible?
It's easy. You take a slice of pizza and bury it in some soil and give it a lot of water and sunlight and wait for it to grow. They say talking and singing to it helps, too.
Munch, I hate to tell you this, but,
One day, little buddy, you're gonna grow up to be a big plant. Baby pizza plant in the ground. One day you'll make pizzas big and round. I'll harvest those pizzas and say gracias, por favor. And then I won't have to wait for Pasquale anymore. Pasquale always says, Mancha, you can't rush to perfection. But that's just an excuse.
Munch, I'm trying to tell you, it's impossible to grow a pizza plant. It just won't work.
It won't work, but
you just can't bury things, sing a goofy song, and expect them to grow a magical plant that makes the thing you buried. I mean, if that worked, do you know how many tennis ball plants I'd have out here? Man, I love chasing tennis balls.
But Jasper, I...
All right, look, Munch, we don't have time right now. We need to be inside getting ready for the next show. Just take my word for it, okay?
Okay, but...
All right, we'll see you inside.
Hey, Munch, this pizza from those pizza plants you grew? It tastes great. Who knew you had the magic touch for farming?
Yep.
You up for a game of tennis after the show?
Well, sure. Well, the tennis ball plants just sprouted some fresh tennis balls.
Awesome.
Making statements, a world is listening.
Don't underestimate the spoken word.
One wild idea or demented afterthought can make you sound like a silly bird.
Okay, guys, it's 10 seconds. 10 seconds there. 3, 2.
Chuck E. Cheese Action News with your Chuck E. Cheese Action News team. Sports by Dougie the Duck Lucky. Our consumer watchdog, Mr. Munch.
Bow wow.
And chicken licking with the weather. Now, from Chuck E. Cheese News Central, here in Chuck E. Cheese's, it's the Chuck E. Cheese News with your host, Chuck E. Cheese.
From the game room to the salad bar to all ships at sea, let's go to lunch. Flash, a strong weather front is threatening our northern borders. For details, here's Chicken Lickin' with the Chuck E. Cheese weather. Chicken?
Chucky? Well, as Chucky said, this is a strong front of bad weather. Very strong and very bad. When I say it's gonna be strong, I mean strong. And when I say bad, I mean not good.
Everybody gets their bumps, bangs, and boo-boos. Sooner or later, every lad gets his lumps. But instead of sitting there with your boo-hoo, pick yourself up and brush off your bumps.
People usually buy what you sell them if they think you know what you talk about. Try to measure everything that you tell them. Like chicken licking.
The sky is falling! The sky is falling! A piece of it just hit me on the head! Look at that lump! Forget it! You can look at the lump later, because the sky is falling! Put up your water and buy plenty of bottled storm windows, because the sky is falling, and you're seeing it live on Chuck E. Cheese Action News!
Thank you, Chicken Lickin', for that report. We look forward to an update after you've had a long rest. Now over to Dougie the Duck Lucky with Sports Beat.
Thank you, Chucky, and hello, sports fans! I guess everybody knows the news tonight.
The sky is falling! The sky is falling! Climb under yourself! Put a paper plate on your melon! Cause the sky is falling!
Spreading rumors is a short road to trouble. Time has a way of turning liars into fools.
Play it safe by playing straight with your brothers. How can you win a game that hasn't got rules?
Just because you think times are trouble, you have no right to say another's wrong. Listen first before you say what you're thinking. Don't be like Chicken Licking.
The sky is falling. A gigantic piece of it just fell on my head.
What are you doing? Are you crazy?
Listen, it's a good time to get canned goods. If your goods aren't canned, can them. If your canned goods are canned, good. But don't can bad goods.
Now over to our consumer watchdog.
Leave me out of this, Mr. Cheese. They've heard enough.
All right, Mr. Munch. This has been the Chuck E. Cheese Action News, repeating tonight's top story.
The sky is falling, stocks are climbing, the hills are alive with the sound of music. The sky is falling, the sky is falling.
We'll probably share more misinformation in a little while, so don't wander off.
Hold tight, everyone. We'll be right back with the next part of our show, right after this.
The Bear and Two Friends. Two best friends were walking through a forest. Their names were Chubby and Skinny.
Hey, Chubby. You and I are closer than brothers, aren't we?
You bet. Skinny, I will always be there for you no matter what. You know that, right?
That's when Chubby and Skinny swore on their friendship. And just as they did, a big bear appeared right in front of them.
Help! Help!
Skinny quickly ran and climbed up a tree. He sat there with his legs dangling. Chubby, on the other hand, was so fat that he couldn't run away.
Okay, if I pretend to be dead, the bear won't eat me.
Chubby quickly fell to the ground and pretended to be dead. That's when the bear walked up to Chubby and sniffed him. Then he walked away towards the mountains. After the bear disappeared, Skinny came down from the tree and asked,
Hey, Chubby, I saw the bear whisper something in your ear. What did he say?
Chubby looked at Skinny in disappointment and replied,
He said that a friend that climbs up a tree and saves only himself isn't a friend at all.
What?
Kaneda, Carl, Clara, Kyle.
What are you doing over there, Mr. Munch?
Well, I'm just trying to count up all the interesting names of the kids that I meet here, and there must be a million of them.
Well, a name is just a name. It's the person behind it that makes the name special.
Why, you said it, buddy.
I'm not the world's most worldly guy, but that's okay, and I'll tell you why, because I've always got my good name. When people bug me, I pay no mind. Their attitude doesn't ruin my time. Why should I care? I've got my good name. You can take my, no one trans on my.
People have a little bit of trouble with my name.
Believe me, pal, once they got it,
they'll never forget it.
I know what you mean.
I like my job here playing these drums, and I'll be alright no matter what comes. People know me, I got a real good name. Minute by minute and day by day, I make sure my reputation's okay. I'm real careful about my good name.
Okay! You can't take my, no one treads on my good name. Cause I've earned it and I'm proud of my good name. Whatever may come for good or for bad,
everybody out there proud of their good name?
Yeah!
Then is everybody gonna do whatever it takes to keep their good name?
Yeah!
All right then, let me hear everybody say!
All right!
You can take my, no one treads on my good name. Cause I've earned it and I'm proud of my good name.
One more time!
You can take my, no one treads on my good name.
It's time again for that chicken who's checking out the stars, Helen Henny's Hollywood.
Thank you, thank you.
Well, today I'm so excited that my feathers are fluttering. Why? Because I'm going to be interviewing the stars of that blockbuster family comedy, Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. And here they are. Excuse me. Pasquale, what are those shoes doing here? Where are the stars of Honey, I Shrunk the Kids?
Well, there was this weensy little mistake, Helen. You see, these are the stars of another movie called Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Oh, no.
It's about this crazy inventor who makes this machine that shrinks big tennis shoes into little tennis shoes. See?
Honey, I Shrunk the Kids?
Well, it died at the box office. It went straight to video. In fact, Siskel and Ebert gave it 3 odor eaters. Rex Reed called it a turkey in tennis shoes. Newsweek said that it
but
was...
But I can't interview a bunch of shoes.
Why not? Shoes have... tongues?
Oh, well. Thank you for watching, and until next time, remember, when the stars are out, just leave your message on their answering machines. Ta-ta!
It's time for some jokes. Some jokes from Pasquale.
It's time for some jokes. Some jokes from Pasquale. Some jokes from Pasquale.
You guessed it. It's time for more jokes from Pasquale. Take it away, Pasquale.
Oh, thank you, Chucky. I'm a Pasquale the Chef, and I hope you've fastened your comedy seatbelts because of this chuckle car is about to drive. Now, here's my first joke. Why aren't cheeseburgers good at a baseball? You give up? They always bunt. Get it? Buns? Cheeseburger buns? All right. How about another one? What is an astronaut's favorite key on the keyboard? Any guesses? The space bar! Okay, I've got a time for one more before I go. How do you tell a train to eat? Are you ready? Choo, choo! You get it? Choo, choo! Chugga, 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 chugga. Choo, choo! Chugga, 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 chugga. Choo, choo!
Summer and fall.
Winter!
White snowflakes falling down.
Spring!
There were flowers
summers all around.
Summer!
Let's go to the CCC.
Fall!
Leaves are tumbling down.
Go, go, go!
Winter, spring, summer, and fall.
Winter, spring, summer, and fall.
Winter, spring, summer, and fall.
For Pinkfong on YouTube.
Friends and family, bring out the best in you. You gotta treat them with love and care.
If there's a problem or call to celebrate, that's what a friend's for, that's why they're there.
Having friends means you have to be one. Make an effort, give them as good as you get. Pick the plot to tell a better tale. Double up, share a new adventure with your friends. You can't go wrong when a bunny tags along.
All right, Pasquale, it's your turn.
Oh boy, Hansel and Gretel. It's about these two adorable kids in Italy who get lost one day.
Pasquale, didn't Hansel and Gretel live in Germany?
Well, I thought they got lost down around Florida.
Not the way I heard it.
We better let Rose talk, gang, or Hansel and Gretel will never get lost.
Thank you, Mr. Munch. In my version, Hansel and Gretel are traveling a little bit closer to home.
Gee, it's fun to go exploring in strange and far out land. Take a look at what's around the bend.
Get away from things you're used to. Hike a path that's new to you. All you need to take along's a friend.
When you're facing trouble, friends come running on the double. You can face most anything with them.
Keep an eye out for your sister. Stay ready to assist her. That's the way to have and be a friend.
Listen to your better instincts. Check it out before you sail. Oh. Things are never as they seem. Look ahead to where you're going. Don't forget the stuff you see. Everything is easier with a team. When you're facing danger, don't go looking for a stranger. Get a clue, here's what I recommend. Keep an eye out for your brother. Stand up for one another. Keep the boys, don't let them get away. You're gonna make me want my day. When you're lost and lonely, call a friend. If your time and patience ends, you gotta lean on who you know. Gotta go with the flow, live and let it go. That's how to have and be a friend, oh yeah. That's how to have and be a friend.
Wait, don't go.
Well, gang, how do you like all the stories?
Those were great, Rose. Good one.
What's next, Rose?
Mr. Pasquale, I think it's time to give our cast of characters a break, don't you?
Ooh. I'd say they earned it.
All of them? Even the big bad wolf and the wicked witch?
Hey, we're just doing our job, gang.
We'll be right back.
We'll be back, everyone, and we'll see you in just a few minutes. Wow, that show was a lot of fun. And speaking of fun, here's some more coming at you right now.
The Sun and the Wind. One day, the wind approached the sun and asked,
"Hey, sun, who do you think is the strongest in the world?" "It's me, the wind."
"Oh, really?"
The sun chuckled.
"If you don't believe me, let's bet on it."
Just then, they saw a man walking through the field.
"See that man? Whoever can make him take off his jacket wins."
As soon as the wind said that, he started to blow as hard as he could.
"That's strange. Why is the wind so strong today?"
The man held onto his jacket tightly. The wind blew harder and harder. But the stronger the wind blew, the tighter the man held onto his jacket.
"I'm too tired. I can't blow anymore.
As soon as the wind stopped, the sun came out.
"Okay then, it's my turn now. Watch this."
The sun laughed and started to shine as bright as she could.
"Huh? Why is it suddenly so hot? Oh, it's too hot. Oh, whew."
The man started to undo one button, then another, and another. But it was still too hot, so he took off his jacket and threw it aside.
It's too hot."
"See that wind? You embarrassed yourself by trying to show off."
The wind became so embarrassed that he blew away.
Like got. Twinkle, twinkle, hot, hot, hot. Wish I may, wish I might. First star I see tonight. Up above, the clouds so high. Show your face, don't be shy.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above, the world so high. Like a diamond in the sky.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are.
It's time for some jokes. Some jokes from Pasquale.
It's time for some jokes. Some jokes from Pasquale. Some jokes from Pasquale.
Ah, yes. Joke time again. Make some noise for Pasquale the chef.
Thank you, Chucky. That Chuck E. Cheese. What a guy. You know what Chucky's favorite game to play is? Hide and squeak. You get it? Because he's a mouse and the mice squeak? Okay. Here's another one. What did the gopher do when he forgot his pencil? Anyone? Anyone here? He asked to burrow one. I mean, then you did it. All right, one last one for my friend Jasper. Why did Jasper keep stopping the movie? Do you know? He liked using the pause button. You get it? Pause, pause, TV, pause button. Oh, I crack myself up. Well, I'll be doggoned. Hey, get your paws off of me.
Pinkfong on YouTube.
Hope you enjoyed the show. We sure did. If you missed part of it, we'll be starting in a few minutes, so don't go away unless you're getting some more pizza.
The Greedy Dog. One day, while a hungry dog was walking along the street, he came across a huge piece of meat.
Ruff, ruff. Wow, what's this? This is the largest piece of meat I've ever seen.
The hungry dog quickly bit down on the meat and thought,
yum! All mine! I'm going to enjoy this all by myself! Hum.
A little later, the dog came across the bridge over a stream, and he started to cross it. But, to his surprise, a dog in the stream below was looking at him with an even bigger piece of meat in his mouth.
Huh? Hey! That dog has some meat, too. And his is bigger than mine. I'm going to take it from him.
The greedy dog started barking at the dog in the stream.
Ruff, ruff, give me that. Ruff, ruff.
When the dog opened his mouth to bark, he dropped his meat into the water.
Oh no, my meat fell. What have I done?
That's when the greedy dog realized that the dog in the stream was his own reflection.
Oh, my meat!
Jungle where nobody goes, there's a slithery snake washing his clothes with a swish swash here and a swish swash there. That's the way he washes his clothes.
Boom body boom boom boogie woogie boo. Boom body boom boom boogie woogie boo. Boom body boom boom boogie woogie boo. That's the way he washes his clothes.
It's time for some jokes from Pasquale.
It's time for some jokes from Pasquale, some jokes from Pasquale.
The intro pretty much speaks for itself. I don't even really know what I'm doing here. So without further ado, here's Pasquale.
Well, thank you, Mr. Cheese. And thanks to all of you. Are you ready for some jokes? Great, I thought so. So, here we go. How did one phone ask the other phone to marry it? He gave it a ring! Ring, 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 ring! You get it? Okay, a next joke. You know polka music isn't the best of music. Accordion to me! Accordion! It's too funny! Just too funny! All right, folks, one more before I go. Why did the ceiling feel so popular? You give up? It had one big fan. A fan! You get it? Uh-oh!
Pinkfong on YouTube.
Showtime. Showtime!
People have as much fun as the Chuck E. Cheese cast members.
I don't know, Zachary, but I do know there's only one reason why we have as much fun as we do.
What's that?
Well, that reason is every one of our guests. And here's a great little number the band cooked up just for you to let you know how we feel.
Thanks, Jeremy. And we'd like you to know, each and every one of you touches our hearts and makes all of our days brighter.
You sure do. And we feel you're the star of our show.
That's right.
Yeah, absolutely.
When you're here, it's a special thing. When you're here, we start harmonizing.
When you're here,
it's awesome.
It's fantissimo.
When you're here,
you're a part of our show.
Wonderful, magical synergy.
You're here.
The jazz becomes so much fun to sing.
You're here.
When it's you that's up and listening.
When you're here.
When you're out there having fun.
It sure puts a smile on my face.
There's no doubt.
Just remember, you're the reason we're here.
You're our special guest.
Thanks for stopping by.
You're the greatest. Come back and see us real soon.
Because you're part of our family.
Goodbye.
Bye,
bye.
Bye-bye. Y'all have a good one.
You know, I love to travel by plane, by car, but my favorite way is by train.
Mine too.
It goes a little slower, so you get to see a lot more.
Yeah, there's nothing like going to sleep with the sound of the rickety-rackety rolling of those wheels.
Oh, yes.
Bye.
back at you in a little bit.
It's time for some jokes from Pasquale.
It's time for some jokes from Pasquale, some jokes from Pasquale.
It's that time again, arts and crafts with Pasquale. Okay, I'm just kidding. I'm gonna leave the jokes to him. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, Pasquale.
Thank you, Chucky. And hello, everyone. I hope you are ready for a good time. Because I've got some great jokes for you today. So, are you ready? Because here we go. What do you call an octopus that tells the jokes? You're going to love this one. A knock-knocktopus. Knock, knock, who's there? Octopus. All right, here comes another one for you. What is a drummer's a favorite vegetable? Any guesses? A beet. You get it? A beet. Dum chucka dum doo pow. Oh, I crack myself up, Pasquale. Okay, I've got a one more for you. What do you get when you put too much pepper in your pasta? Give up? Macaroni and sneeze.
Achoo!
Achoo!
Pinkfong.
The Sly Fox. In the middle of the forest, a large piece of meat was on a path. A dog and a cat both saw it at the same time and ran for it.
I saw it first, so this meat is mine.
Meow! No way! I got here first, so it's mine.
A passing fox stopped for a moment to help them.
Stop fighting, guys. All you have to do is just split the meat in half.
So the fox started to tear the meat into two parts with her sharp teeth.
Uh-oh, this one is bigger.
The fox pretended to think for a moment. Then she took a bite of the bigger piece. Uh-oh, the fox took a bite that was way too big. The larger piece was now smaller than the other.
Now this piece is bigger. Oh, this one is bigger again.
The fox continued to take bites of each piece of meat, pretending to make them equal. After all of the bites, the fox ended up eating all of the meat.
I'm so sorry. It looks like I've eaten all of the meat. Well, I better go then.
If we just shared, we would have eaten some meat. Instead, all we did was feed the fox.
Grandpa shark, do 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 do. Grandpa shark, do 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 do. Grandpa shark, do do.
do-do-do-do-do-do, Grandpa Shark.
Let's go hunting, do-do-do-do-do, let's go hunting, do-do-do-do-do, let's go hunting, do-do-do-do-do, let's go hunt.
Run away, do-do-do-do-do, run away, do-do-do-do-do, run away, do-do-do-do-do-do,
run away,
safe at last, do-do-do-do-do, safe at last, do-do-do-do-do, safe at last, do-do-do-do-do, safe at last.
It's the end, do-do-do-do-do, it's the end, do-do-do-do-do, it's the end, do-do-do-do-do, it's the end.
There are 10 fish in the sea. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10.
1 fish, 2 fish, 3 fish, 4 fish, 5 fish.
6 fish, 7 fish, 8 fish, 9 fish, 10 fish.
Oh no!
Here comes a shark, here comes a shark, here comes a baby shark.
Run away!
Run away, run away, go home!
5 fish, 4 fish, 3 fish, 2 fish, 1 fish.
There's no fish, there's no fish, there's no fish in the sea.
Only shark, only shark, there is only a baby shark.
I want to be your friend.
This is a baby shark, baby shark.
Pinkfong on YouTube.
It's time for some jokes. Some jokes from Pasquale.
It's time for some jokes. Some jokes from Pasquale. Some jokes from Pasquale.
Hey folks, I'm a Pasquale the chef. And I hope your seats are in the upright position, because this laugh jet is about to fly. So, here's my first joke. What did the royal cook bake for the king and a queen's dinner? You give up? A castle roll. Not a castle roll. A castle roll. Oh, I'm so clever. All right, next one up. When can you fit a birthday cake into a wristwatch? This one's a little tricky. When it's a little battery. You get it? Cakes need a batter. And the watches need a batteries. All right. Last one for now. What kind of a boat is the most affordable? You think you got it? Okay, I tell you. A sailboat. You gotta buy your boats when they're on a sail. I'd do one more, but I'm afraid I don't have a time for an anchor. You got it? An encore? Anchor?
Something you should know. Take it with you wherever you go.
Say it when you get up in the morning and late at night when you are yawning. You're a poison who's special indeed. Got all the brains you need to succeed. Don't get down, whatever you do, 'cause I can see by looking at you
that you're a winner. A lucky winner. We're all winners.
Hey Munch, how you feeling today?
Tell you, Chucky, I'm A-OK. Having fun, playing my piano. Let's say hi to our favorite soprano.
Hi. Thank you, Chucky, and Mr. Munch, too. Who could lose with good friends like you? Always giving me encouragement, so I'll return the compliment.
'Cause you're a winner.
Yes, you are, Munch.
A lucky winner. We're all winners.
Oh, yeah.
Jasper, Jasper, you faithful old hound. Won't you spread some Jasper wisdom around?
Don't know much, but I do know one thing. All you people are really something. Like Pasquale, who's always so kindly. He has always been right there behind me.
Don't be silly, you deserve my respect. From the day I met you, I could detect
that you're a winner.
This means you
a lucky winner. Who are watching the show? Remember this when it's time to go. What is fact is not braggadocio. It's okay to let the world know that you're a winner.
Let everybody know.
And I'm a winner. We're all winners. Lucky winners. We're all winners. Winners!
Chucky, I just love it here. All the kids.
Pizza.
Yeah, Munch, the pizza too.
If you people enjoy yourselves as much as we do, then I think the world's gonna be a better place.
Tell them, Pasquale.
I got a feeling this is gonna be a special day. Me and my friends are making plans to go out and play.
When I wake up, I'm excited 'cause a new day's waiting for me.
Get back soon.
What's up, guys? It's Kidz Bop Egan and Kidz Bop Panda here on set. Oh, we're just chilling. You got anything to say?
Hey, it's Giovanni from the Kidz Bop Kids, and we're on the set of ABC.
The Boy Who Cried Wolf. Once upon a time, there lived a shepherd boy.
Oh, I'm so bored. Isn't there anything fun I can do?
The shepherd boy came up with an idea, and he ran into town yelling,
"Ow! Wolf! Wolf! There's a wolf!"
Where? Where's the wolf?
The village people all came out with sticks and clubs.
What? A wolf?
There's a wolf?
There's a wolf?
Yeah,
a wolf!
Yeah,
where is that wolf?
I just made that up. I can't believe I tricked you all.
The village people became furious, and they left. The boy had so much fun playing the wolf trick again. A few days later, the boy played the wolf trick again.
Ow! Wolf! There's a huge wolf!
The people came out running with their sticks and clubs again.
I tricked you again!
You evil boy! We're never going to fall for this trick again!
The people were even more furious this time when they left.
No!
Come on, let's go.
Then, one day, a big and scary wolf really did appear.
Help! Please! Someone help! There's a wolf! Really! There's a wolf!
Huh. There he goes again. Does he think we're going to fall for that trick again? That's absurd!
Hearing his cries, the village people didn't move an inch. But it was at that time that the wolf ate all the sheep.
Oh no! My sheep! My poor sheep!
shepherd boy who guarded all the sheep. He was very lonely, he did not hear a peep. One day he decided to play a nasty trick. He yelled, "Wolf, wolf, wolf!" And all the other shepherds came running quick. And all the other shepherds came running quick. There is no wolf, there is no wolf, all the shepherds said. There is no wolf, there is no wolf, so don't cry wolf again. Don't cry wolf again. Then suddenly a wolf appeared, hungry for a sheep. He cried wolf, 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 but nobody heard a peep. And you know what happened? The wolf took all the sheep.
It seems these days in many ways people are working out. It's true, don't you know, everywhere that you go, it's what they're talking about.
Everyone needs to come up with a way to work's best for them, you see.
Devised a plan to burn off these extra calories. I'm country dancing myself in shape, and it works for me just fine. I'm country dancing myself in shape and reducing my waistline. Well, you can do your aerobics and you can lift your weights. I'm country dancing myself in shape, and it's really got me feeling great.
Well, day and night I'm eating right, feeling better all the time. My heart's beating good like I know that it should. My boots and jeans fit just fine. Everyone needs to come up with a way to weigh best for them, you see. So I devised a plan to burn off these extra calories.
I'm country dancing myself in shape, and it works for me just fine. I'm country dancing myself in shape, and reducing my waistline. Shape, and it's really got me feeling great.
Did something to this country stuff,
and in my jeans start to fit and snug.
Everything on me snug.
I start to exercise my way by dancing and cutting the rug.
Boy, I could get used to this.
You know, I'd try this, but I'm afraid I might break a few fiddles.
Well, you can do your aerobics and you can lift your weight. I'm country dancing myself in shape, but it's really got me feeling great. I'm country dancing myself in shape.
We're two-stepping out of here, but we'll be right back. See you later.
Should not, I've got somebody back home.
It's been a long night here
and a long night there,
and these long, long days, oh, they're everywhere.
Hold up now,
you seem nice,
I will not lie,
but if you ask what I'm doing tonight,
gotta be like,
oh baby, no baby,
you got me all
wrong, baby. My baby's already got
all my love.
So nah, nah, honey, I'm good. I can stay a while, but I probably should not. I got somebody back home, and I should really call them on the phone. Nah, honey, I'm good. I can stay a while, but I probably should not. I got a bitch you would do to another. I will stay true.
I'll stay true.
got me all
wrong, baby. My baby's already got
all my love.
So nah, nah, honey, I'm good. I can stay a while, but I probably should not. I got somebody back home, and I should really call them on the phone. Nah, honey, I'm good. I can stay a while, but I probably should not. I got a bitch who would do to another. I would stay true.
The Tortoise and the Hare. There was once a tortoise that slowly crawled through a forest. Boing, boing! A bouncing hare saw the tortoise and made fun of him.
Make way, make way! I'm bouncing through! Hey, Slowpoke, didn't you hear me? Move out of the way!
The angered tortoise stopped walking and said,
Hey, let's race to the top of the mountain and see who gets there faster.
You think you can beat me? Fine, let's do it. Ready, set, go!
So Hare bounced away and Tortoise slowly crawled. Boing, boing, and away went Hare. While Slowpoke Tortoise crept and crawled with bullets of sweat dripping down.
Now where is Tortoise? Wow, he is so far behind. It'll take him forever to catch up. So I think I'll take a nap.
While Hare slept, Tortoise never stopped walking. Ba-lump, ba-lump. Sure enough, Tortoise crawled past Sleepyhead Hare, and he crawled to the top of the hill.
Hey, Hare! I beat you! Ha 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 ha!
Huh? What? What's going on?
Hare woke up and scurried up the hill. But it was too late. Tortoise was already resting under a tree at the top of the mountain.
No, this can't be. I lost to Slowpoke Tortoise.
Wash like this, rub like me, right hand, left hand, up the ring.
Attention! Penguins, begin!
Right, Flipper!
Have you ever seen a penguin dancing here? When you look at me, a penguin you will see.
Penguins, attention! Penguins, begin! Right, Flipper!
Last Flipper!
Have you ever seen a penguin dancing here? When you look at me, a penguin you will see.
Penguins, attention! Penguins, begin!
For Pinkfong on YouTube.
Go around the world in nothing flat, using music as your welcome mat. Learn some real fun, huh, figures and facts. Tuning into Chucky's Geography Rap. Spin that globe!
Australia's what? We're gonna see!
The home of the famous Crocodile Chucky!
It's down in the southern hemisphere, so its seasons are the opposite of what we have here.
It's cold in July, in December it's hot.
I ask you, is that confusing or what?
Australia is the home of the kangaroo.
And the mixed-up duck-billed platypus, too.
Now millions of sheep in the outback graze
to give us wool for sweaters that we wear on chilly days.
And a sport that's fun, if you get the hang, is throwing the Australian boomerang.
The people speak English, like me and you.
But their accent makes it into something new.
So as we pack up our tucker bags and go on our way, we say thank you, Australia. Good day.
Hey, everybody. I have a game we can all play.
All right.
I hope it's something that I can win.
Really, a game that you win or lose. You see, it's like this.
Here's a little guessing game we can play. Let's look down the road 10 years from today. When people come and listen to Mr. Munch's band, what kind of music will they hear then?
Well, let's hear from the leader of the band.
Now, rap music sure to be the happening thing. In 10 years' time, rap music will be king. It's the music of the street, and I'll tell you what'll happen. A decade from now, the whole world will be rapping.
Guessing game, guessing game.
All right, Munch, your predictions are duly noted.
I want to know what Jasper thinks.
Well, instead of rapping it, I think I'll sing it.
It don't take lots of schooling to figure this one out. Country music's the only style we could ever live without. It soothes you when you're sadly and excites you when you're gladly. I reckon every boy and girl will someday love it madly.
Don't sit down!
Guessing,
yeah, you can take Jasper out of the country.
No, but you can't take the country out of the kid. Helen, you can't take a guess.
Listen, boys, when it comes to music, there's no guessing here.
Move all the fellas, cause I've got some news. Nothing beats dancing for shaking.
When you're my size, you tend to crush people's feet every now and then.
Mr. Chucky, I believe it's your turn.
Rock and roll music is the way things are going. Electric guitars really get my blood flowing. If you come and see this band 10 years from today, I guarantee you we'll be rocking away.
Ooh, tear it up, Chucky.
Well then, thanks everybody.
The kids.
Mama mia, how can I be so stupid? Take your gun.
This game is fun, but we'd rather see a
Pinkfong.
Pinkfong on YouTube.
Here's a little ditty the band cooked up. We hope it's your stamp of approval. You get a pen and some paper and write a little letter to tell me how you be. You tell me what is new and how do you do and fold the letter in half, you see. You put the letter in an envelope, a stamp on the envelope. It makes me so happy. Now please don't fail to put your letter in the mail so the mailman can bring it to me. Hey, the mailman's bringing, he's bringing my letters. He's bringing my letters to me. He's bringing my letters, he's bringing my letters to me. The mailman brings my letters, I feel so much better when he brings my letters to me. The mailman's bringing my letters, he's bringing my letters, so send me 203. Alright, you ready for this? With a smiling face, they go place to place, bringing mail to everyone. In rain or snow, it's off they go until their work is done. Bringing pictures and magazines, postcards and toys, and sometimes bills galore. I was sick, dropped a note to say get well. And a new gal, Shirley, with her hair so curly, really thinks I'm swell. My old pal Davey, you know, the one in the Navy, says he'll be home real soon. And we'll all holler when we win the $1 million sweet sakes this afternoon. Oh, the mailman's bringing, he's bringing my letters, he's bringing my letters to me. Oh, the mailman's bringing, he's bringing my letters, he's bringing my letters to me. We'll have a nice talk when he comes down the walk to say hello to me.
Go around the world in nothing flat. using music as your welcome mat. Learn some real fun, figures and facts. Tuning into Chucky's geography rap. Spin that globe!
The place we're going to visit has 31 states. It's Mexico, a republic with a variety of traits.
To the east of Tijuana, there's the great desert sands. Just south of Sonora, you find rich farming lands.
Now let me tell you about a state where I'd like to go. It's the Western movie filming state called Old Durango. Like the actors that film there, Mexicans also ride on their rodeo horses where they take great pride.
I know they like to rodeo, but something else is true. They also like the beaches where the sea is a warm blue. You can take a train or take a plane to visit Acapulco, where you'll see men dive from great big cliffs and think they're kinda loco.
Now, one last thing before we go. I almost forgot. It's the Yucatan Peninsula, and boy, is it hot!
So gracias, dear Mexico. You've been a real nice host. But now it's time for us to leave and say to you, adios!